You know, we've done a lot of stories that are out of sight, but I wanted to do one that was out of this world. Today, we are in Springdale, Arkansas at Explore Scientific to learn more about a company that I bet you didn't even know was here. Our show features local businesses that interest us that maybe people don't know are in our Northwest Arkansas area. So really fascinated to learn more about your story, Scott. And so really what got you started in optics?
Oh, cool. Well, I'm glad you guys came in here. My interest in optics start when I'm really young. I'm probably 8, 9 years old, and it's the Apollo program. You know, and when JFK said, you know,
by the end of the decade.
Yeah, by the end of the decade, you know, so it's the early 60s and we're going the end of the decade. You know, we've just learned how to get rockets up into the sky without exploding. OK,
we're supposed to put a human
in there.
And
now we're going to put a human and walk around on the moon.
Right.
A lot of people thought that JFK was nuts. OK, I'm living in Texas as a kid during this time. OK. And I remember any time if there was something about space, the Apollo program or whatever, you know, they're letting kids out. We're watching on a black and white TV. It's rolled out in the hallway and we're transfixed. We're learning every aspect of the Apollo program.
It became a national pastime.
Yeah, absolutely. A passion.
And then young Scott got enamored by that?
Yeah, like me and a zillion other kids, you know. So I am begging for my parents for a telescope, okay, because I want to see the moon and everything. I watch Buzz Aldrin and Neil Armstrong land on the moon, walk on the moon and stuff. By this time, I am hounding my parents like crazy to have a telescope. They yield finally and they buy me a very small telescope from Kmart. I still have it.
Wow.
Okay. But my parents were really cool too because they would let me tear things apart. Okay, so I tore all my sister's toys apart, rebuilt them, tore my toys apart, rebuilt them. The telescope was really cool because I was taking the lenses out, the eyepieces out, and I'm seeing how these things work, you know, and I'm learning how a telescope actually works at that time. I really kind of honor my parents in a couple of ways. One of them is with my telescope that I keep on my desk. And the
your
other
first
one is,
telescope,
yeah,
your very first
right?
one. That's cool.
And my parents travel around a lot. You know, I'm a military brat. So I'd always wanted to have a trailer, you know, an Airstream trailer. And so I got one of those. And that's named after my mom. You know, I'm like one of those guys that never wanted to have a real job, right? I wanted to have something that I was passionate about. I decided that at 12 years old, you know.
And then how did it, you know, kind of domino effect from there?
I just was really enamored with optics. I started a hobby in photography that turned into a profession by the time I'm 15. And, but only 5 years later, I'm getting reintroduced to astronomy. So 1980 is rolling around, I'm 20 years old. Almost immediately, I run into people, because now I'm using big telescopes and I'm selling them in my store, and I'm meeting people from the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, from Palomar Observatory. I start to meet astronauts and stuff like that. And I'm going, what an unbelievable community. I mean, what other community could you get involved with where you're gonna meet explorers, discoverers, you know, as someone with no formal education in this,
right.
Okay? So I'm in the right place, the right time. Because I'm selling more and more telescopes, it's attracting this audience that is just amazing to me. So today, I mean, I know people like Buzz Aldrin, okay? He owns one of our telescopes. I work with the Jet Propulsion Laboratory as a volunteer, okay? I'm surrounded by optics all day long, and I get to talk to discoverers and explorers at different levels every
yeah.
day. It's awesome. I always had this thing in the back of my head that I wanted to have my own business.
And actually so, manufacture your own telescopes?
Anything, you know, just that it had to be my business.
Right.
It was just a promise I'd made to myself that I thought I should do this for myself. I should do this to work out my ideas and my designs and to work into the community in the way that I want to.
Yeah.
And so that's the genesis of Explore Scientific, which I started in 2008. The brand Explore Scientific is a brand I came up with. You know, I wanted the company's name to be what it does. We're a licensee for National Geographic, PBS, Discovery, and we have sold telescopes all over the world.
So we've talked a lot about space. We've talked a lot about your passion for that, which is what you got into this, telescopes, but microscopes, rifle scopes, all sorts of optics that you have morphed into and that you are expert in now. So talk to us about the different arms of your business.
Okay. Well, we are diversified like that. The core of our business is astronomy and telescopes. We probably sold 4 or 5 million telescopes since I started the company. Okay, we have little telescopes that sell for, you know, 50, 60 bucks, all the way up to models that go up for thousands of dollars, you know, over $10,000, some of them. So there's a telescope for everybody. Microscopes is an important part of our business because that's looking the other way, right? Instead of looking out into space, but it's all about exploration and kind of self-discovery. So people can have this moment of personal discovery and exploration in their own backyards, you know?
Or with a microscope in your own bedroom.
In your own bedroom, exactly.
Out in, you know, your deer hunting.
Deer hunting, that's another way, you know. I'm not a hunter myself, but we have people on our team who are expert hunters.
And, binoculars.
Binoculars, right.
But this is a perfect, kind of a perfect storm for you because there is a ton of outdoor stuff in Northwest Arkansas.
That's right.
Binoculars, rifle scopes for sure.
And that's another reason why I'm here.
Yeah.
You know, because this area, you have people that go outside more, okay, in general. Okay, they love hiking and camping and hunting and, you know, there's a culture of that here.
Let me talk about emotions for a minute. You're finally doing what you always dreamed to do.
Yeah.
Few people can really actually say that and mean it. Mm. So talk about that a little bit, and then how gratifying is it to see a young person or any amateur come in, grab a telescope, and get that excitement to go and do some exploring of their own? Mm-hmm. Those two things have to really mean more than any monetary value.
Yeah, I'm glad you asked that question because that's probably the most important part of it. Having your own business is a roller coaster ride. Okay, that's not for everybody, I know. The reward of it, though, is when you see the good that your products have done. And in astronomy, I think that the way it opens people's minds, that it encourages them to go and study harder or to get excited about science, okay, because they had this experience of seeing Saturn's rings for themselves live, and they saw an exploded star in another galaxy, and they saw a comet. Okay, and they go, wow, my life is not on this, in my neighborhood, okay? It's not on this little ball called Earth, okay? It's not even just our solar system. And it starts to sink in that you're seeing the light, the fossil light of a galaxy millions of light years away. And it's not, this light is not a copy. This is not a reflection. These are photons made in those stars that took off millions of years ago, traveling across space, and now some of them are being funneled through the telescope and actually hitting the retina of your eye. The real, actual, not copies, but the real photons made in those stars.
Wow.
Okay? And you can see it. You see, there's like this tipping point. They realize, whoa, I'm having a connection. You'd be surprised how good even a small telescope is. I mean, I have...
If you know how to use it.
If you know how to use it, right? That's the secret, so, you know,
but... Kind of like golf clubs. They're good if you know how to use them.
Yeah, and a great golfer can actually use a pretty bad set of golf clubs and hit a good game,
That's right. But it seems like an under-tapped hobby in this area.
Right.
You know, it seems like it could do a lot of growing in terms of a local hobby.
Right.
For Northwest Arkansas.
It is growing. A few years ago, Explore Scientific gave away telescopes and microscopes to every school in the Springdale School District.
Wow.
Okay, so everybody got telescopes. That inspired some science teachers both at Northwest Arkansas Community College. I think there's people also at University of Arkansas. And we have formed an organization called NWA Space. The leader of that is Catherine Auld. Catherine Auld is a professor at NWAC, and she saw an opportunity to get a 24-inch historic refractor. Okay, and this is the long telescopes. So she got a 30-foot-long, 50,000-pound telescope donated to NWA Space, okay? And it's in storage right now, but we are at the point where we're ready to do fundraising to get
it set up,
get it built. Yeah, so they'll have a planetarium, a telescope like that. And so, I see it as being a perfect dovetail to some of the other community things that are going on, like the Amazium and the Crystal Bridges and, the Momentary, which is starting up, So yeah. A program like this where you can go and look through a massive telescope like that, be in a huge planetarium, get hands-on with science and stuff, I think will inspire a lot of young people and families.
Yeah. Hey, are you subscribed yet? You better do so in order to never miss a segment. Click below and subscribe today.